summer 2018, the summer of change.
And the summer of champions.
Exactly. We'll get to that later. But no, we're doing a little change here at Clash of the Nerds for the podcast. Some of you may have noticed Izzo has been missing for the last couple weeks. Unfortunately, just circumstances with his personal life. I shouldn't say personal life, because that would...
I think it's more scheduling.
Scheduling, yeah. Scheduling with church and things like that, I should say. Yeah, personal life doesn't sound right. Scheduling with church, thank you, that was a better word. Scheduling with church, because he basically runs the entire choir and the sound system and the band.
He is
their church band. He's unable to do the podcast anymore, unfortunately, which is why he has not been here.
Yeah.
We were hoping that something could work out and we could do scheduling around it, but with me coaching little man's baseball and things like that, it doesn't work out, unfortunately. So yeah. Izzo, for the time being, won't be a part of the podcast. It's unfortunate. We miss him dearly. Izzo, we miss you. I don't know if he watches the podcast, because I know I don't watch it after editing.
I don't watch it after editing.
So we're switching the name, which the name doesn't make sense now because Sean is joining us on the podcast today. But the new name of the podcast is no longer Let's Podcast. It is now The Two Man.
Hey.
Power Trip. Taylor.
Yeah. I want to be in it.
That's what kind of Power Trip it is. I punch dogs. But no, Two Man Power Trip.
Now, are we still going to play video games from time to time? Not all the time.
From time to time, we will be playing video games, but it's no longer solely about video games. It's going to be a three-pillar podcast now. And we're also going to try to keep it to 45 minutes to 30 minutes. It's no longer going to be an hour plus.
It's going
to
be all about integrity, intelligence, and intensity.
We're going to talk video games. We're going to talk movies and entertainment and sports and entertainment. And by sports and entertainment, I mean we're going to talk about this team right here, your world champs. And we're also going to talk about sports entertainment, i.e. wrestling's coming back.
We know you've been clamoring for it.
It doesn't get its own podcast.
It probably shouldn't have been.
Like it did. But we're going to, when something big happens in the WWE, in New Japan Wrestling, in Ring of Honor, I almost said TNA, but we're never going to talk about them.
I never hear about TNA.
No. Anymore. We might bring it up on the podcast. It will get its own little small... It will get its own small segment, but it's not going to be a big part of it. But we are going to talk a lot about movies, music, and video games. I should have just said movies and video games. We're going to talk a little bit about music. Usually when I get a hankering to talk about music, because anybody who knows me knows music is a big part of my life. But yeah, those are some of the changes that are going to go through with the podcast. Also, I know you all are used to the podcast going up on Tuesdays. That's because we usually would film it on Friday or Saturday, edit it, put it up, get it ready to go Monday night. But now we're going to start filming probably on a Wednesday or Thursday. So look for the podcast late in the week. We're going to try to get it up towards the end of the week. Maybe if we do it on a Wednesday night, we'll have it up by Friday.
That should be doable.
Yeah.
Friday night.
So, as of right now, there's no set day like we normally have for when the podcast goes up. We're going to play it by ear. We're going to figure out what works best for the editing schedule. Also, what works best to get traffic. Because, as you know, with any kind of YouTube channel, you want to try to generate the most traffic possible. So, we're going to try to put this out where we're going to generate. So, maybe we film on a Wednesday, but we still put it up on a Tuesday because Tuesday's going to get us the most traffic. Maybe put up Monday. We're going to play with it. We're going to see how it goes.
So make sure you hit that bell.
Definitely hit that bell so you're notified.
Sorry, Jeff, for screwing up your regular audio podcast schedule.
No, because we can still get the audio up. It's just the video side of it. Also, I know I've gotten some questions about Buff Nerds. Buff Nerds has not gone away. It's been hectic coaching baseball. And we had a huge
scheduling conflict that really just threw everything off.
Yeah, so Buff Nerds is not going away. I think by the end of the summer, I'll get some new workout plans done. We'll start filming again. See, I'm down. Like, my cutting plan, the cutting plan that we have posted, I know we didn't do the last week of it. Unfortunately, we were unable to film it. But I went from 220, I'm down to 205. So I dropped 15.
I mean, last time I weighed myself, I was at 180, which was surprising to me, but that also tells me that I might have lost a little bit of muscle.
So, I mean, we're going to continue Buff Nerds. That has not gone away permanently. It's just, oh man, did we underestimate how busy the spring was going to be. So, it was ridiculously busy. Things are starting to calm down now because the regular baseball season's over. I won't be coaching again until the fall. So, most of my summer is going to be opened up. But I want to talk about this. The Washington Capitals, because those of you loyal to us have known throughout the years, around May, I start to believe, and I always get my heart broken.
Well, I always tell him he's not allowed to believe until the finals.
But this
or
year...
Or at the very least, till we get past the Penguins.
But this year my belief was not for naught. We did it. We are your Stanley Cup champions.
I didn't start believing until like game 3. Yeah. I was like, oh, we might actually do this.
And we went to the parade yesterday. Well, Sean and I went to the parade. Nelson could not get off work. The parade was a blast. We met new friends. It's great. Like, I don't know if you saw the picture I posted. Like, there were these two guys just like right next to us at the parade. Because there was this guardrail set up, almost like a WWE aisle way.
Yeah.
Which I had asked a couple event security staff. Some were like, oh, it's just to get like, so we can get people out who need medical attention. And some were like, oh, the players are going to come down this way. So we didn't know. We were hoping the players would come down that way. We'd kind of given up getting really close to the stage. That was really packed. So we're like, we're kind of close. We'll be by these guardrails. So if they do walk this way, maybe we can touch the cup. Sean drew a picture of TJ Oshie.
Nice.
That he wants to get
to. So now we have to go to practice.
Oh, don't worry. We were going to go to Kettler anyways. Because now I know where Kettler's at. I never knew where it was.
Yeah, I was just about to ask him, like, how was getting out of the city? Because I remembered you guys got home kind of late, but I just assumed you might have
also. No, got late at normal time. No, when I got home late, yeah, that was baseball practice.
Yeah, I didn't know if it was baseball practice because by the time I got home,
it was kind of cool. Like, the people right by us, they were like, they're like, hey, you know, if the players do walk this way, we'll give you some beer if you just let us bum rush and, like, touch the cup. Like, done. So they shared their beer with us.
He's what was me, not with him.
I didn't really care. Like, I can reach out and touch the cup.
Yeah.
I wanted him to have a chance to give his picture to Oshie. So they shared their beer with me, and then another group next to us shared water with Sean and Morgan. It was a good time. Like, we were around. That's like good. A lot of cool people had some cool conversations because we were out there for like 4 hours just to get a spot and then waiting for the team to get there.
Yeah.
But it was a blast. Like, it started to get like kind of draggy before they got there, but then once they got there, spirits picked back up. It was a lot of fun. So it was fun to celebrate as a city. I can't wait to see the final numbers for that.
Man.
Because I think it's going to be close to 500,000. Because there was almost 100,000 people at the viewing party. And when the Redskins won in 87, they drew 500,000 people.
Oh, wow.
And yes, it's the Redskins. Football will always be number one in D.C.
Yeah.
But the city's grown so much since then. And there's a lot of bandwagon jumpers on the Capitals thing. I wouldn't be surprised if it topped 500,000 people. Mm. But it was a lot of fun. Just amazing to see that sea of red. So if you haven't seen it, if you go to like NHL.com or just any kind of sports website, you'll see pictures of the event. You just see all this red out in the crowd.
Oh, yeah.
It was amazing.
Yeah, so like my class was watching on the big screen, the parade.
Uh-huh.
Apparently they saw me hanging off the guardrail.
I doubt they saw.
Because they showed the middle.
Mm. Man, it's a possibility. I mean, it's a possibility.
Yeah, I was joking with a friend of mine online. I was like, look for me in the crowd. I'll be the guy in red.
I saw you.
Actually, I did joke because yesterday was a buddy of mine's birthday up in New York. And he's a diehard Rangers fan. But he loves Ovi. Like, he loves Ovi to death.
Mm-hmm.
So he was rooting for us in the Stanley Cup, which is unusual for a Rangers fan. But I did root for the Rangers in 94.
Mm-hmm.
That was the only time. That was the first. No, it was before Gretzky. But that's the only cup they've ever won. And they hadn't won in 54 years. So I was kind of pulling for the Rangers.
Yeah.
Just as like, hey, you know, we're all together. I won't pull for them ever again. But that one instance I was pulling
for. Did you hear what the Caps did for the Knights?
Dude, wait, hold on. I'm not done with my story. I know I go off on tangents. So it was his birthday yesterday. So I was like, hey, man. Happy birthday. Make sure if you get a chance, watch the parade today. I'll be the naked guy streaking across the stage, making sweet, sweet love to the Stanley Cup.
Your name
is obviously a joke.
I know, but if you did do that.
Yeah, oh yeah, just go like Google search Ovechkin with the cup. It's been amazing. And what I've loved, and I'll let you talk about the nice thing, and I did see what you're talking about,
yeah,
is that hockey fans all around the country are loving the Capitals right now. Because this team is super likable. And B, it's just they're not like celebrating on their own. They're taking the cup to Georgetown, playing in the water fountain.
They're going to bars and restaurants.
They're celebrating with everybody.
Yeah.
Constantly, when I'm on my run on DC, which is how I got into the Captain America movie,
yeah,
I'm checking Twitter because I'm like, if they've got this cup out somewhere,
you're just gonna
I'm
start
hauling ass.
Who's that crazy guy looking like he's Thor running as fast as he can?
Why is Thor stealing the Stanley Cup?
All these tweets at Chris Hemsworth. Why are you stealing the Stanley Cup? I'm not even in DC.
That's what a man who stole the Stanley Cup would say. But, oh man, it's just been great. It feels like a dream. And I think we mentioned this like last year, the year before his podcast. I got Nelson into hockey. You said you were a Sabres fan as a kid, but you're never really into it. But when you moved in with me, I got you kind of into hockey. And it's been a rough ride for Nelson because he's just been. But the thing's like, I've been a diehard since 91. Like, 91, I really got into hockey as a kid because of the NHL games. And just Wayne Gretzky, I just really got into hockey. So I naturally became a Capitals fan, local team, just like I'm a Redskins fan, Nationals fan, things like that. But man, has it been a long ride for me. It's been almost 30 years as a fan, just disappointment after disappointment.
Yeah.
So just to finally, it's euphoria. You don't think about it. It's kind of like, I remember when the Redskins won in 91, I was 8. It was like, I was just thinking about the odds because I think there were 30 teams in the NFL in 91. I know there are 32 now. I think there were 30, maybe 28. But I think it was 30 in 91. I know if I had a chance to like count in my head, I could figure it out.
Yeah.
I'm going to say 30. I was just thinking the odds. Like one, like if you don't think about skill, and when you're 8, you don't think about skill level of teams, you're like, that's a 1 in 30 chance of winning. So it seems like, can that really happen to us? And it did then. And it finally did now for the Capitals. And for them to get that first cup, I think what makes it feel more special is all the heartbreak.
Yeah.
Like, as a Red Sox fan also, because D.C., we didn't have a team until I was 24.
Yeah.
So I chose the team. I hated the Yankees. I hated the Orioles. Chose the Red Sox as a kid because they were rivals to both those teams. And for anybody who wondered why somebody who grew up in Northern Virginia, D.C., hated the Orioles, go look up why D.C. didn't have a baseball team. The Orioles were to blame. But, so, again, as a Red Sox fan, to win that one in 2004 and then the Caps 2018,
yeah,
because you go through that heartbreak,
yeah,
it makes it feel special, unlike a lot of bandwagon fans. And, by the way, any new Capitals fans, I welcome you with open arms, but definitely this championship means more to us than it does to you because you weren't there for all the heartbreaks. And even, like, the newer Capitals fans who have just been fans for the past, like, 5 years,
yeah,
yes, that was a lot of heartbreak. But I hated the Penguins long before these people hated the Penguins, because I remember in 94, yeah, 95, Lemieux, Jagr, bouncing us from the playoffs. So it's just kind of, it's like, I think the longer you've been a fan of a team and the more heartbreak you've gone through, the more these championships mean, because you've done it longer.
Yeah.
You've gone through, you've gotten the start.
And you pretty much just hit it on the head right there, because
yeah,
I've liked the Capitals for a while, almost as long as I've liked the Sabres, but like you said, I really didn't watch hockey that much.
Yeah.
So.
And you've enjoyed this run.
Yeah.
But I think I can.
But I can. I can definitely see that
as an outsider, yeah, for you looking at me, you've seen how much I've.
Oh yeah,
this.
Yeah, exactly. I'm not gonna like speak out of turn. I'm not gonna talk like I've known the team since their inception. But you know, I definitely see what you're talking about there.
Because this is how scarred I am as a fan, and we're gonna get to E3 in a second. Unfortunately, sorry. Big Capitals fan. Anybody who knows hockey knows how big this is for this city and how much we love it. But when we beat the Penguins, when Cousy got that goal in overtime,
I couldn't believe it.
I was in disbelief. I was waiting. I was legitimately waiting for
them to wave it off.
To wave it off.
Yeah.
To say no goal, offsides, whatever.
You didn't even see the goal, right?
Yeah, because the camera angle, because it trickled through Murray's legs.
Yeah.
And the way the camera angle was, you never saw the puck go in. Like, I didn't know until I saw the referee point and I heard Paul McGuire yell, "Go, Capitals, go!" It was just one of those things, like, because it was just so slow when it went through his legs, you couldn't see it on TV.
Mm-hmm.
So, again, like, A, I was shocked, and B, it was just one of those things in my mind. I was waiting for the ref to wave it off.
You're waiting for the screw
job. For a host, not even a screw job, just I was waiting for the Capitals to have screwed themselves somehow. Mm-hmm. Like, not even the refs, like,
coming waiting for Earl Hebner to just ring the bell and just run away.
Just, like, not even waiting for the refs to screw us, but waiting for behind the play, somebody did something stupid to cost us the game.
Yeah.
So it's just one of those things, it's just kind of like, when you're, as a fan base, you're beaten up so much, you expect the worst, But that's what makes the best so great. Because you're like, oh my God, it did happen. And then I filmed him, because I would have just watched the final puck drop of the Stanley Cup, but I wanted to get his reaction, and his reaction was priceless. Because there's so many times I've seen his reaction, but not had a camera to record it, that it's just kind of like, man, I wish I could have saved that.
Yeah.
So it's like, after the icing and the puck, and it was just a formality to drop the puck, because there's no way the Knights could tie it. Mm-hmm. Got the camera on him to film his reaction. It was great to have that. And that's why I took him to the parade, because sports are fun for us adults, but I think it means something more as a kid. Because I know I cared more about those kind of things as a kid. Now, granted, at the Capitals won when I was a kid, I might not have cared as much now, but I'd never seen this before. Like, if the Redskins win another Super Bowl, I'll be happy. But not as happy as I was when I was 8 and 5.
Yeah, when I watched them.
Well, yeah, because you've never seen it. not in person. I've seen
them
videos.
Win a division in 2012, and that's it.
Yeah. So that's kind of catch talk for the week. That's our touch on sports.
But real quick, I just wanted to say, if for anyone who didn't see the really cool display of sportsmanship, the Capitals took out a full page ad in a Vegas newspaper congratulating the Vegas Knights for an unbelievable season, which I thought that was really cool and really classy on their part. That's really all I wanted to bring up there. You saw that, right, Josh?
Yeah, I did. It was awesome.
Yeah, so that was a cool little thing. They had I can't remember it word for word, but you know, they didn't have to do that. And the Vegas Knights, they did have a great season.
And it was a classy organization. Like, I didn't like some of their players, like.
It got a little dirty, it got chippy. Yeah.
But it happens like that. Like, the frustration builds over.
Yeah, because you're the competitor.
From just like a step back, like just watching the NHL playoffs, the Knights never really had much adversity in the playoffs. They kind of steamrolled everybody.
Yeah.
And so this was their first, because they had never lost. So the Capitals won 4 straight games to win the Stanley Cup. The Knights, all season long, never lost 4 straight.
Really?
Yeah, so they experienced something in the Cup they had never experienced at all during their inaugural season.
Okay.
They never lost 4 straight games.
Yeah.
So sometimes, like, and Marc-Andre Fleury was a big reason why they were in the Stanley Cup, but he was playing out of his mind. He was playing better than what he was. So it was just a matter of time before he regressed to back to what he was.
Before it started breaking down.
And the thing is, what got them to the Cup was their defense kind of sucks. But Andre Fleury was playing so great that you didn't notice that he was making up for it. But the Capitals the Capitals outcoached the Vegas Knights. Barry Trotz outcoached them and came up with a game plan to expose that defense and to just put Marc-Andre Fleury on his heels. And just as a team, they didn't have an answer. They didn't have an answer for the Caps forecheck. They didn't have an answer for the Caps once the Caps got a lead. They kind of like made a wall at the blue line.
Yeah.
And the Knights would dump and chase, but the Caps would get the puck, get it out most times. And when you got a guy like Alexander Ovechkin, your captain, diving in front of shots and blocking them, that's when you know the entire team's bought into the system.
Yeah.
And they're all in. They're not going to lose. This team, I said this to a couple friends of mine who are football fans, this Capitals team reminded me a lot of the 82 Redskins who won their first Super Bowl. Because this Capitals team, you had your superstar in Alexander Ovechkin. And it's hard to say if I go outside the hockey, but outside of D.C., who's considered a star on this Capitals team. I figure if you ask most casual hockey fans, they can name Ovechkin.
Yeah.
Before the Stanley Cup, by the way. I don't think they could name Nicky Backstrom. I think the hardcore fans could.
Probably.
The hardcore fans could probably name Holtby. But out of those three guys... Yes. No, I'm talking about the hardcore people who aren't Caps fans.
Oh. Well,
I don't know if they can name any other player on the Caps team. They might get one or two, but if you said, who are the superstars on the Caps? Most people say Alexander Ovechkin, and would be hard-pressed to name another.
Yeah.
So this was a team built around one superstar, but a bunch of role players who knew their job.
Yeah.
They knew exactly what they had to do, and I think the key to the Caps winning wasn't Alexander Ovechkin. It wasn't Kuznetsov. It wasn't Oshie. It wasn't Nicky Backstrom. It was the fourth line anchored by Jay Beagle and Devontae Smith-Pelly. Devontae Smith-Pelly had 7 goals all season.
And Eller.
But he had 7 goals in the playoffs.
Carlson was also in
defense. Carlson's defense. He plays defense.
He wasn't the fourth line, though.
Well, the defense will play with all the lines.
True.
But Smith-Pelly and Beagle, but like Beagle had these hustle plays that canceled out icings, and then twice, once against the Lightning, once against Vegas, found Smith-Pelly after canceling out an icing, and he made an awesome goal. And Smith-Pelly had the tying goal, which I got an autographed picture of. I can't wait for that to come in. Not to mention Hopi save. I can't wait for those pictures to come in.
I'm waiting for my shirt.
Because I need my Capitals shrine to go, because I have a shrine to the Redskins Super Bowls, the Red Sox World Series, and now I finally get a shrine to the Capitals Stanley Cup. So
did you get a chance to look up any frames? Because I haven't gotten any chance.
Well, the Holtby one comes framed.
Okay. Oh, you're talking about the stuff you bought from NHL. For some reason, my mind already went to the newspapers that I found.
Oh, no, I haven't even looked up frames. But I did get an email from Michael's Arts and Crafts. Your team has just won the Stanley Cup. We've got jersey frames. We can frame newspapers for you. And
yes.
So that was hilarious.
So I'll be going to do that.
Exactly. So, I mean, we're going to figure that out.
And then I have to figure out where I'm going to put it in my
room. Yeah, I got to figure out where I got to rearrange the
picture. Yeah, you have more of a job to do in rearranging stuff.
But, so yeah, we're going to touch on E3 now. But I think we're going to film this weekend and we'll do a 4-week E3 wrap up.
So this is just.
Have you watched any E3 coverage?
I watched some recaps. I watched I've seen the majority of the Xbox One.
So what are your 5 favorite things you've seen about E3 so far?
Definitely Nintendo stuff. that's tops right there. Smash Brothers. I'm actually really surprised that they went so far as to bring back everybody that's been in a damn Smash Brothers game, though I don't know who that last character they introduced was. The dragon, is that from Metroid Prime?
Oh, Ridley.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, that I wasn't familiar.
Not Metroid Prime, just Metroid in general.
Oh, just Metroid in general. Yeah. Okay, I wasn't sure. I guessed that it was Metroid just because, you know, it was facing off with Samus.
Yeah.
A lot. I'm definitely excited about that. Mario Party 8, I usually never get excited or disappointed by it. It's just like, I'm going to play it, I'm going to enjoy it, so I really don't have that much of an opinion. Though, I thought it was cool how they're using two connect, or not.
Hey, Sean, earmuffs? That's a drunk party game.
Yeah, yeah.
Look for that this winter.
Yeah. I thought that was really cool.
I've watched Funhouse.
But, other than that, let's see, what else? Did you see... you might not have seen it because I don't know if it was showcased, but I'm curious about it. Hopefully, it doesn't suck. Jump Force. That's the Shonen Jump game with like Dragon Ball, Naruto, and all the Shonen Jump characters.
Oh, I don't know. Was that debuted at E3? Because I saw
something they showed they showed gameplay footage.
Yeah, and they had an interview. I saw something about that before E3.
Well, there was another game like that for the PlayStation 3.
No, but I mean...
Oh, for that particular game?
Yeah, I think I saw it like last week. Like, okay. Something about... Like, a teaser.
Yeah, right? I don't know like that it... Play. Yeah, I don't know that it was, like, showcased, like, say, Gears 5. But I know that they had, like, their... IGN had the little side interview thing. They were interviewing, like, one of the head programmers or creators or something like that. I don't know... I don't remember who he was because he had a translator.
Yeah.
But I'm curious to see how that game is, because the last time a game like that came out for the PlayStation 3,
I remember because we talked about getting it.
Because I was definitely thinking about getting it, but then I heard it sucked, and then we saw it at I think AwesomeCon Or it was one of the ones that Izzo was with us. I can't remember which one it was. It might have been Awesome Con.
The last time we hung out with Izzo at a con.
But it might have been Wizard
World. Richmond.
Yeah, it might have been Wizard World, but it might have been Awesome Con.
If it was Awesome Con, it was last year.
Yeah. Then.
No, we saw Anthony last year too.
Because it might have been the year that you met that one friend through Izzo. I forgot his name.
Oh, Jay?
Yeah, Jay. Yeah.
That
would have been Wizard World. That's when I met Jay.
Was it? Okay. I mean, those two cons kind of blend together to me. So, yeah. So
we're
Jump
also
Force.
Old.
Yeah, we're also old. Jump Force looked interesting to me. Obviously, Kingdom Hearts 3 getting a release date.
I will believe
but
that
yeah, I will
that
believe
that
it when, I have,
when it comes out.
I will believe it when I have it in hand.
Yeah.
I told my friend that online. I'm like, I'll believe it when I have it in hand. Simple as that. But it looked really cool. And I can't wait for that. Even though I've been waiting for, I don't know, like 10 years for that.
At least 10 years
for that.
I was shocked that there was nothing new about Final Fantasy VII shown, which means Square Enix probably shouldn't have shown it. Mm-hmm. What? 2015 when they
yeah they should they should not they again. Should not have shown that but then again they shouldn't have shown freaking Final Fantasy 7 remake.
So what I got excited for of it, obviously Smash Brothers.
Yeah.
I love that Snake's back because I didn't particularly like playing it on the Wii.
Mm-hmm.
Because I don't like using the Wii controllers for
how
it.
How about the GameCube controllers being compatible?
Are they compatible?
You didn't see that?
No, because I didn't watch Nintendo Direct. I just
Well, I think that's what I saw. I think I saw like a Nintendo video. So at the end of it, after they introduced Ridley, they're like, "Oh, and also, you can use
Sweet,
your GameCube." Because
I got a shit ton of those.
Yeah, same here. I got a couple of them.
But Gears of War 5.
Oh yeah, Gears 5.
Though I'm not so much into Gears multiplayer as much anymore.
Oh, but the story is fun.
Yeah, I enjoy the story.
I mean, that's usually just like the three of us anyway.
Yeah, I like rolling through co-op doing
yeah.
that.
Well, and since Tyler has an Xbox, maybe we can get him for once.
Maybe get back on
if,
it, yeah.
If, you know, he's not too busy doing his shows.
Get the gang back together. Me, you, Tyler, Double R,
B-Hop.
And since Kevin doesn't have an Xbox, Sean can fill it for Kevin.
Yeah, exactly.
Same maturity level.
Well, yeah, he's filling in for Chandler and Kevin.
Yeah. I was disappointed that Crackdown got postponed to
that was a little disappointing.
February next year.
I hope that it lives up to any expectation.
You know what I'm kind of excited for?
What's that?
Is Fire Emblem.
Cause I see Fire Emblem.
I've actually. Only I'm not a big real-time strategy RPG fan,
mm-hmm.
so I don't like sitting at my console doing it. But I really love Final Fantasy Tactics Advance for my Game Boy Advance. So those are the type of games I can play on a handheld. So that coming out for the Switch, because I've always wanted to get into the Fire Emblem games. But again, RTS has never been my thing.
Yeah, that's kind of.
But that coming out on a Switch, I'm definitely going to give it a go.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you mentioned Mario Party. They're making a Funko Pop Gears of War game.
I did see that. That was kind of funny to me.
So I'm interested to see what that is. There's a new Halo. I'm not too psyched about that.
It looked cool.
You know, honestly, I think Sony had a terrible showing because, A, I've never been to The Last of Us. Sorry. BioShock Infinite was a way better game.
I've never been to Halo
5. Spider-Man. The more I see the Spider-Man game for Sony from Insomniac, I don't want to play it.
Really? I'm like the exact opposite. I've actually... The costume has finally grown on me.
See, it has nothing to do with the costume. It's the gameplay. It's just like, I don't think I'm going to like playing it.
Hmm.
I hope they have a demo so I can try without buying it.
Yeah.
Because I want to like it. But I don't think it's going to live up to the Spider-Man the movie 2. I don't think it's going to be that good.
You know, it's so weird. It's so weird. No. Spider-Man 2.
On the PS2, GameCube, yeah.
No, well, it's not that one, it's Spider-Man 2.
No, but like...
But the other games, yeah, the original Spider-Man trilogy is what you're talking about, yeah.
Yeah.
It's so weird to me that is still the measuring stick for Spider-Man games. It's been how long? That game on the original Xbox.
That's the measuring stick, but also I think Spider-Man 2 was just as good. Ultimate Spider-Man was just as good.
I mean,
Spider-Man games Activision put out right around then year or two
bouncing
really good. Like,
I mean, they're all basically
Spider-Man 2, the one that was the comic book one, not the movie one, I actually like better than the movie version.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, those were all really good games.
I thought that the one with all the other Spider-Man, the Edge of Dimensions.
That guy.
I heard that was.
Reviews.
I thought that was.
I
like
was wanting
the
to
new,
play it, but never got around.
Yeah, I thought that was like the new It Spider-Man games.
No. Still the bar set at Spider-Man 2.
Which, you know, it was a great game. Don't get me wrong. I had it on the original Xbox.
You know what my biggest disappointment of the show so far has been? I think I should say at all, because I think all the conferences are done. Was no Avengers game from Square Enix.
Oh, that's right.
The one that was like,
come on,
way to go, dog.
Come
the
on,
one that,
knock
the,
my wiffle ball bat down.
The one that they like, I don't even think it was like last E3. I think it was like two E3s
like
ago.
Like two E3s ago.
It wasn't.
It's like
it was at the most two. It could have been last year's old year's one year together.
Yeah.
But yeah, I thought that we'd at least see that. And when
yeah, they
it
had like a
there.
Little teaser, and they didn't even have an official name for it yet. Right?
Yeah, no. So the fact that that wasn't there, that was a big disappointment.
I'm kind of surprised.
But
by that, yeah.
I will say, Fallout 76 debut. I can't say that I'm disappointed. I thought maybe it was going to be something completely different, like an online co-op Fallout game. I'm down, but I really thought it was going to be something drastically different. So I'm disappointed in that. Like, I didn't want it to be a battle royale game. I'm glad it's not that.
Oh yeah.
But I'm disappointed that it's basically Fallout but multiplayer.
See, like,
because I was hoping that the way Bethesda was kind of teasing it along, that we were gonna get something really special.
And damn them for getting Country Road stuck in my head.
Oh, I've had Country Road stuck in my head.
If Fallout or something did a battle royale and like everyone started playing that, they would do what Fortnite did to the original story. Ruin it. Because now Fortnite doesn't have a story. So
oh, by the way, I need to download it. Fortnite's free on Switch. I gotta download that for my Switch.
Oh, is it free?
I really like Save the World, but like you need someone online to play, and like no one plays Save the World because it costs money. So like they took every story out of it, because now it's just.
But yeah,
which is sad because I don't. Because you know what? I don't actually even like battle royale.
Yeah, it's kind of like I was.
No, because everyone tries.
Oh, I know. I know why I was talking about. I was talking about this with the guys that I met at the parade and with Morgan at the parade. Some kid had. Sidney Crosby is someone who hides in the bushes in Fortnite.
I hate those people.
Which we all laughed at. Mm-hmm. But we were all talking, it's like I have nothing against Fortnite, but it's just not my cup of tea.
Yeah, I just don't, I mean, it's,
I
it's
like
cool.
Save the World.
It's
well,
cool.
No, I
just
really
like
enjoy
it.
Fortnite, and
yeah.
I know nothing about
Save the World.
It's cool. Yeah,
it's cool.
I just don't enjoy it.
It's just not for me. I do wish we could kind of get back into playing, like, the original Fortnite again.
Yeah.
Because I did like that, the horror
see,
mode.
Yeah,
like,
you cannot do Save the World anymore because you gotta do it online with someone. Everyone's playing Battle Royale.
Is that the regular one?
Yeah, regular Save the World?
Well,
yeah.
Me and Mr. Nelson can play it.
We all don't play it.
Oh, I know. Well,
we also don't even play Overwatch right now, which we need to.
I know. I'm real like with the exception.
We
of,
need to get back on.
With the exception of dipping into God of War periodically, I haven't had time to play video games.
Well, I mean, yeah. I mean, you've been dipping into God of War.
I've regressed
to freaking Xenoverse 2, and occasionally I pick up my new 2DS, but. Yeah, I need to really get back into, or actually start playing Dragon Ball Fusions, since I haven't. And I haven't really gotten a chance to really play it yet, but it looks pretty cool.
Yeah, it's, also Dragon Ball Fighters is coming out for the Switch, I saw that.
I did see that, that'll be interesting, I would like to, what am I talking about? I have Fighters, I'm an idiot. I still haven't gotten a chance to play that freaking game. Like I probably should go play it tonight.
But yeah, I think overall it's been a decent E3. Sony had the weirdest show. We'll do.
Yeah, I haven't seen anything about.
I think we'll do a more in depth this weekend recap of E3.
Because I don't know anything.
Most of that I left all my notes at home or at work.
You wish you left it at home.
Yeah, because then I'd be here. I took a bunch of notes in my free time, so. I think that's where we're going to end this podcast. So again, the new podcast, Two Man Power Trip, special guest Sean. So like we said, we're going to change the format up. We'll play video games from time to time in it, but for the most part, it's just going to be this kind of format of podcast. We're probably going to film it in the basement where we normally film the podcast.
Should we have a quick mention of the new title holders of New Japan?
Yeah, go ahead.
So, out of nowhere, because I didn't know it was happening, Kenny Omega wins the IWGP World Heavyweight Championship. And then also, Chris Jericho apparently isn't coming back to the WWE anytime soon because he won the IWGP Intercontinental Championship from Naito. So, congratulations to the new champions. The Elite is back together, apparently. It was a really surprising thing. Actually, you know what? Also, I don't know if you saw this, Josh. The WWE was advertising the Elite on WWE.com because apparently they're going to face the New Day in a Street Fighter tournament.
I saw that Xavier Woods. Him and Kenny Omega were tweeting about it. Yeah.
Oh yeah, the best frenemies. I really want to see them
Each
other in dance dance.
Again, we're gonna talk more about wrestling in a future podcast because of the Stanley Cup playoffs. I have watched zero wrestling. I want to say since April, I really haven't watched any wrestling.
I mean, it's been, for me, it's been like 3 weeks since I've actually paid attention.
Because usually, I don't
Money in the Bank is a Sunday.
I don't go this deep into the Stanley Cup playoffs. Usually once
You're usually back on wrestling.
Yeah, once the Caps are done, I'm a bitter bitch and I stop watching because I'm mad. I'm mad. But this year, I went all the way!
Yeah! I'm glad!
And what sucked is, man...
I'm glad.
CM Punk is usually like live tweeting like Stanley Cup matches and stuff like that. But because he was training to get his ass whooped.
That made me sad.
I didn't get to see him talk about the Caps. Of course, the year we win, he's like not talking about it. Because he always talks shit about the Caps. So I just wanted to see him
CM Punk
be bitter and be like, congratulations, Capitals.
Oh, I
don't know why he hates the Caps.
I don't know.
I remember because he's a Blackhawks fan, so we're not a rival. Yeah. So I don't know the legit reason why he hates us.
Ovechkin killed his child. I don't know.
Maybe. I don't know.
No, he didn't do that. But
I hate the Penguins, but it's a legit reason. I hate the Islanders, but it's a legit reason.
I did jokingly tweet at Edge.
I did see that.
Thank you for rocket strapping the Caps to the cup.
Yeah.
As what he said on their podcast, like just in passing, he wasn't saying anything bad about the Caps. He's just like, I don't see them going to the cup. That's all he really said.
I didn't see them going in the cup.
But, you know, neither did I. But the fact that he was talking about it on the podcast, whenever they talk about someone or something, they get shot right up to the top. They get a rocket strapped to their back, and they go right to the top.
See, like, when we went down 2 games to Columbus, and they made history because that was the first time they made a playoff back-to-back, I was like, are we really losing to this team? We've made playoffs almost every year.
Yeah.
And then once we dropped down 2 games, I'm like, okay, I lost faith. And once we passed them, I was like, I have faith again. When Penguins won, I was like, oh no,
I said
to Nelson, I said to Morgan, I was like, if we're gonna win the cup this year, we gotta beat Pittsburgh. Because if we don't beat Pittsburgh,
we're not good enough.
No, it's not even that good enough. Pittsburgh fans are like, oh well. You didn't have to face us to go to the cup, so it doesn't count. Mm-hmm. So no, not only do we win the cup, but we punch them in their mouth in their home building to win that cup.
Though I did think it was nice of them to congratulate us.
Fun fact. So the night we won the Stanley Cup was also the same night that the Bullets won the championship.
Oh, yeah.
Away in Chicago.
No.
Game 5.
You already messed it up.
No, I didn't.
Wow.
The night the Capitals won the Stanley Cup was the 40th anniversary of the Washington Bullets / Wizards winning their first NBA title in Seattle.
Dang it!
I'm 90% sure it was Game 5 for them, too.
It was Game 5.
That's the podcast this week. Yeah. Two-man power trip. We're going to be doing some more videos now that I'm done coaching because, like he said, he made All-Stars. Thank God I'm not coaching All-Stars this year.
Thank goodness I made All-Stars.
But, so, we'll be producing more videos. Look for more stuff this summer. We're going to do a lot of cool stuff, like video game plays. I'm thinking we need to do some skits. You and I have been talking back and forth about some funny skits to do. So we're going to work on some stuff. It's going to be... This is like the rebirth, the baptism, the bat mitzvah, bar mitzvah of Clash of the Nerds.
Whichever one's for the boy.
Bar mitzvah. Bat mitzvah's for girls. Yeah. Just depends on who you talk to, what gender we are. We're gender fluid. We believe in all.
And then we can have a quinceañera for joy.
Yes. Okay, anyway, everyone, I'm not saying goodnight Tokyo anymore. Goodnight Washington, D.C., you Stanley Cup champions, you sexy bastards.
District of Champions, can't wait for that district to come in.
Capital
of
Hockey. Rock the red.
Woo!
Night, everyone.
Woo! My head is hot.